Hello everyone, I'm the Beveler guy, and today... This is getting out of hand. This is my third video on the subject. My channel is starting to look like a building channel. Which is ironic because I'm not even good at 3D modeling. Let me talk about the improvement to my Beveler plugin before this channel becomes 100% beveling tutorials. If you have limited time and only want to learn about the new features rather than the story of how it happened, I'll leave a timestamp in the description that will let you skip directly to the features. Without further ado, let's get into the story of how this plugin update came about. After I published my plugin, Beveler, a month ago, I started thinking about other forms of beveling that I could add to it. I discovered by trial and error how to bevel objects using spheres, but it requires a bunch of objects. I attempted to add a new toggle setting to my plugin and added a 90% complete beveling process using spheres before I realized that the process freezes Roblox Studio until it finishes beveling the object. This is due to the process creating 30 parts and then unioning the result. At that point, I was thinking, this won't do. I can't have Studio freezing on users because it'll slow down their development time. So I threw out my new code and decided that I would have to start the process from the ground up so that it would be optimized.
You've got mail.
I received a message on Roblox from someone on April 19th, but of course I didn't see this message. Whether it was due to the fact that I only develop for Roblox, which means that I rarely open the website, it could also be due to the fact that I was probably watching YouTube videos because I have nothing better to do during this crisis. The world may never know, but I eventually saw it on April 21st. The message was from a person who tried my plugin and wanted to know if I could add a beveling option that uses spheres. I thought this was humorous because I had tried to do this exact thing 2 weeks prior and had postponed it. Their message had reminded me that I needed to work on it, so I got to work. Over the next 3 days, I worked on the features and the new process that I created worked with 23 parts instead of the original process that required 30. Then the problem came back. The process froze Roblox Studio for around 22 seconds. I tried adding coroutines as one of my friends suggested to speed up the process, but it still froze Roblox. I added wait statements, but nothing seemed to help. Then I added debugging timestamp info in 2 places in my code. I placed 1 time duration counter before and after the beveling process, and another at the beginning and end of unioning the objects. The process of creating 23 parts? Oh, that only took 0.002 seconds for some reason, but the unioning process was 22 seconds. I had been trying to optimize the object creation process, but the unioning process was the actual culprit. After wasting a bunch of time trying to optimize something that was already extremely fast, I realized that I should just add a disclaimer to the project so that users will be aware of the performance impact. So what big improvement did I make to my plugin? Well, let's talk about that. The previous version of the plugin is on the left, while the new version is on the right. I had to increase the minimum widget size, but the plugin now features various user interface improvements. The visual improvements are the outlines around buttons and text boxes. I also added checkbox options for users to have the choice of unioning the final result. If they don't want the plugin to union the final result, the plugin places all the objects into a model. This is useful if you want to preview what the object will look like before unioning it together. Toggling on the weld parts checkbox option will give users the choice of welding the objects together if they don't want the plugin to automatically union the parts together. Additionally, I added the toggle switch between the original beveling with cylinders only and the beveling option with cylinders and spheres. I changed the original cylinder beveling process to one that I used in my first beveling video, which removed the need for negate parts. This should be easier on Roblox to union together as it removed 2 steps from the final result. Some fixes that I've added in this update are the slider, slider limits, and the undo redo history. The slider behaved erratically sometimes when jumping from the slider maximum limit to the slider minimum limit, or when inputting a number to the text box. I changed the tween services easing style from elastic to linear, which should reduce some of the jarring effects. I had to add a new dimension to the slider limits for the sphere bevel type. This was due to the fact that instead of only needing to worry about X and Z directions with a cylinder bevel type, the spheres play a major role in the maximum size of corners. Before, I had assumed that Studio had archived whenever I used the unioning function on parts to save the previous state, but sometimes undoing the beveling process will make objects disappear completely or other stuff to be undone as well. I implemented the change history service to my plugin, so now it sets a waypoint before and after the beveling process, which should allow Studio to properly undo the actions that the plugin does. In practice, however, it seems to do the same thing as before and make the object disappear when undoing. I'd recommend saving a copy of the object before you press bevel object, as I have no control over guaranteeing that undo will work 100% of the time. The final new feature that I would like to talk about is the message pop-up. This pop-up will appear when the object is beveled or whenever the plugin has a warning for the user. Previous versions of this plugin sent the information to the console only, but with the severe beveling type causing temporary freezes, I had to add a disclaimer so that the user would know that the plugin wasn't broken. Well, that seems to wrap up all the new features that are present in the latest version of my plugin. I didn't expect to make such a dramatic improvement over the original version, but it just happened. You can check out the plugin by clicking the link in the description if you don't have the plugin already. If you like the narrative form of scripting updates, let me know, and I'll see if I can make some more videos formatted this way. But I'll still probably make quick tutorials as well, since I know that not everyone has time to listen to lengthy videos. I hope this video has been informative, and if you have any scripting requests, whether new plugin ideas, suggestions for future videos, etc., let me know and I'll see if I can fulfill the requests if I have time. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Also, I'll have a video tomorrow of how to bevel objects using spheres with a manual way. I guess I'm not done being the bevel guy just yet.